I'm in the process of installing the two bellows in this box. This bellows was attached to these plywood strips. The edge was shimmed out to the same level with strips of leather as the leather for the bellows. This strip of wood was glued to this bellows and sealed along that edge. And a piece of this foam window door sealing tape was placed on this strip of wood. And then I used these clamps to compress that seal and then installed these four screws. The leather was installed on the reservoir in exactly the same manner as the bellows. This time I have the seam in the front. And one advantage of the reservoir, you can see inside. You can see how those stiffeners work. You can't see inside of the bellows after you get that installed, so that's kind of interesting. Because the wood is fairly narrow right here, my only area for the leather to seal is right here. So I carried it all the way down to here. And then I took another piece of leather and I glued it around to this side so that this surface is fairly flat and even. So we'll call this a shim. I shimmed this to the same thickness as that. Then whatever I choose for a manifold will have a much better chance of sealing against that flat surface. I didn't really know what to seal this with, so I used a piece of duct tape. This area will be pressurized to 0.18 psi. So if there was a leak, a pinhole or anything where air was trying to escape, the pressure would be on this side. It would push that tape down and seal that hole. There's not going to be any pressure coming the other way, which would be inclined to push that tape loose. The reservoir will have sealing foam or a seal all the way around the perimeter. The discharge is on this side. I'm making this as an air supply for testing pipes. The crankshaft will be here, the connecting rods will be here, and my discharge can come either straight through here or out to this side. It'll be a lot easier to get to. I put a piece of duct tape over the pressure relief valve port. And these pieces of tape will keep these jars of bolts and nuts from sliding away. And the output side of the reservoir, I've covered that with duct tape. They say to put about a kilo of weight on top of here. I don't know if that's a kilo or not, but it's fairly heavy. Pump that up. It should hold pressure for at least 10 seconds, and this is doing that, so. Deflates a little bit. It's not perfect, but I don't think it needs to be.